Okay, this morning I'm gonna be just walking around.
Good morning.
This morning I'm gonna be walking around Lennox Bridge. So let's just go into a bit of the history of Lennox Bridge here while we're standing here. It says here in 1831, when asked to prepare plans for the town of Emu Plains, the surveyor, General Major Thomas Mitchell, insisted first on marking a permanent line of road at the eastern escarpment of the Blue Mountains. A deep gully encountered along his proposed route offered him the opportunity to construct the substantial stone bridge that would be a model for others planned to build along the system of the great roads. Mitchell employed the services of experienced master mason David Lennox, who arrived in the colony in 1832, appointed superintendent of the bridges of Lennox Bridge. Lennox worked on the bridge between 1832 and 1833 with a gang of personally selected convicts who he trained in skills of stone masonry and bridge building construction. Usually using locally quarried stone, the bridge was completed in the early July 1833. It was the first stone bridge erected in the mainland of Australia, described by Mitchell as somewhat of an experimental work. Lennox Bridge formed part of the main route of the West for nearly 100 years. Following a period of closure, the bridge was restored structurally and strengthened in the late 1970s, and it was reopened to traffic in December 1982, almost 150 years after Lennox and his convict work toiled through the summer of 1832 to 1833. Lennox Bridge is the oldest stone arch bridge on Australian mainland, located amongst bushland in the Blue Mountains in the escarpment. In recognition of its significance, it is listed as a state on the state and the local heritage registers. That's an interesting just piece of history to start off with. Now let's just go for a bit of a walk and explore this place. Let's just take a walk. Here you can see we're on the, there's a one-way street that comes down from the Great Western Highway that comes into Lennox Bridge here. It's two ways coming down this road until you hit the bridge, and then it's one way the rest of the way down towards Penrith. A lot of walkers, bike riders and all that ride around this area. It's also a good walk for kids because it's a fairly simple walk. So that's coming to the end of the walk. And yeah, it's an easy walk for kids. Get a lot of joggers around here. There's some parking spots, but there's not much. Tends to get a lot busier later during the day. And I'm coming early in the morning. So if you're going to visit here and just bring the kids for a walk, it's a pretty good walk. It's not hard. People walk their dogs, but they tend to walk them on their chains here. I think because of the amount of people that walk here. But yeah, it's definitely worth a visit here. Now, I'm going to go back to my car now. As you can see, we're coming back to the bridge.